The Congress Party's Karnataka manifesto has created quite a chaos in the country. Today, the Bajrangdal workers stormed into the Congress office in Jabalpur and vandalized it. This comes a day after the Bajrangdal workers staged a protest near the Congress office in Mangaluru and burnt the party manifesto released for the upcoming Karnataka elections. In Jabalpur, the members of Bajrangdal cleared out and vandalized the Congress office and Patrakar Bhavan. They not only surrounded the office but also tore the posters there and pelted stones. As soon as the news of the incident broke out, a large number of Congress workers reached the now vandalized office. The workers gathered and reached the Kotwali police station to lodge an FIR. The video of the entire incident is now going viral on social media. The comparison of Bajrangdal with PFI has cost the Congress dearly. Not only in Madhya Pradesh but also in Chhattisgarh, VHP and Bajrangdal have opened a front against the state government, Congress. Bajrangdal created a ruckus in front of Chief Minister's residence in Raipur on Thursday and tried to burn the effigy of Congress National President Mallikarjun Kharge while protesting. Jabalpur Congress leader Dinesh Yadav reacted to the incident and said the BJP is engineering such plots, giving it communal colour to win polls. He further alleged that Bajrangdal couldn't have carried out such an attack without police involvement. The former national president of Bajrangdal, Jai Bhan Singh Pavaiya, in Gwalior said that the manifesto issued by Congress in Karnataka, in which the party promised to ban Bajrangdal, has been prepared sitting at the house of Rajmata, referring to Sonia Gandhi of the Congress. Pavaiya said that the banning of Bajrangdal is an excuse to help the vote bank of the Tukde Tukde gang of terrorists. I want to ask the Congress, what kind of politics is this, by taking the names of PFI and Bajrangdal together and comparing them. The Congress manifesto was released in the presence of former Karnataka Chief Minister Siddaramaiah, the KPCC President DK Shivkumar and Congress spokesperson Pavan Khera. In the manifesto, the Congress had said that it will take decisive action as per law, including banning organizations like Bajrangdal, the Popular Front of India and others. Taking the controversy to the next level, former Minister and BJP MLA K.S. Ishwarappa burnt a copy of the Congress manifesto after a press conference on Thursday. Countering this, Congress President Mallikarjun Kharge said that Ishwarappa had insulted the people by burning a copy of the manifesto. It is a close competition between the Congress and BJP in Karnataka as the assembly elections are to be held within a week's time, that is on the 10th of May. The counting of votes will be done on the 13th of May.
One India channel and never miss an update.